very warm good morning to you all. This is Ummul Kher. I am Assistant Commissioner Probationer in Indian Revenue Service. I cleared UPSC exam, which is considered as one of the most difficult exams in this world, in my first attempt, as Shalini told. I'm doing my PhD from Jawaharlal Nehru University in International Relations. And I've been associated with Indian disability movement for quite a long time and have represented Indian youth with disabilities at several international platforms. My identity of becoming a bureaucrat or a researcher is a bit secondary and transient. The most important identity that I take pride in is that I'm a self-made person. What I mean when I call myself a self-made person is that I collected my bits and pieces of myself and of my bones from the slums of Hazrat Nizamuddin area, where most of my neighbors used to be the rag pickers, the cobblers, the vegetable vendors, and rickshaw pullers, where the highest aspiration for the girls used to learn how to sew the clothes and how to master the embroidery, where most of the girls used to leave the school by their fourth standard or fifth standard. And in this environment, I was living alone because I was not able to get, because of some reasons, support of my family. And to fund my education, I used to give tuition to the students after returning back from my school. And the tuition classes used to start from 3 p.m. in the afternoon to 11 p.m. at the night. And as the area was a bit impoverished, I used to charge 50 rupees a month. And that used to be without any Sundays, without any break. And it went on for years and years and years. And in this manner, I completed my education. In this grim situation, the source of inspiration for me used to be the stories of Lal Bahadur Shastri, Subhash Chandra Bose, Helen Keller, APJ Abdul Kalam, Martin Luther King. And I used to try to draw the similarities between, say for example, my story and story of an orphan boy whose name was Lal Bahadur. And later he became the Prime Minister of India. And in this manner, in that slum, in that starving situation, I never let the dreams in my eyes die. So, in this manner, my story is the story from the periphery to the center of the society. My story is from the marginalization to reclaiming the mainstream with all grace and with all dignity. Now, the question arises, how many of persons with disability are there in policy making? How many persons with disability are IAS officers, IRS officers, IPS officers, and deciding about society? Then the answer would be, they are negligible. And if we ponder upon and if we think what is the reason behind that, then amidst all the reasons, the most important reason is that we have conditioned our young mind to believe, as yesterday Senator Tom was also telling us, that we condition them that they cannot be anything but the mobile repairer, the beautician as if they are girls, or they can learn how to do the cake decoration, or they can learn how to make candles and papers. And in this situation, we proudly organize Diwali Melas. And in that Diwali Mela, our youth with disabilities, the future of disability community, sit in the stalls and sell the handmade greeting cards and sell the sabuns, the soaps and the shampoos and the diyas and candles that they have learned how to make. It is not wrong. The vocational training is very much required. But the need of our is that at the same time, we also have to organize the career melas. In that, we would be making our youth with disability to interact with the bureaucrats, the top scientists, the doctors and engineers who happen to have disability in themselves, so that our youth would be knowing that the vocational training, sewing and knitting and cake decoration is not only the limit of their life. So as the youth are the future of the country and the youth with disability would be deciding the entire future of our community, I want to tell them from this platform that never ever play small. If you're not able to see, if you're not able to walk, then you are more than the accumulation of your hands or your eyes or your ears. You are more than that. And this, the deficiency of one body part or another cannot define you. And if you are living in one hard situation or another difficult circumstance, it cannot define your future. You should have to believe in your own strength, and you have to have courage to have faith in yourself that you would be able to decide your destiny in the manner you want. So I just want a poem that has inspired me, and you all have also heard this poem a number of times. Just I want to recite the poem in front of you. If you think you are beaten, you are. If you think you dare not, you don't. If you like to win, but you think you can't, it is almost a cinch you won't. If you think you will lose, you are lost. For out in the world we find success within begins with a person's faith. It's all about state of mind. Life's battle don't always go to the strongest or fastest man, but sooner or later, the one who wins is the person who thinks he can. Thank you very much.